guys, it's your girl Shalane. I'm back today with another video. In today's video, we're going to be discussing how to get your business or brand in the media or on television. So if you're just starting a business, you know it's really tough to get your business recognized unless you are really creative or maybe you have a lot of followers, because right now everyone has a business and the market is oversaturated. And we all know that getting your business on television or even just on like a news outlet, that can be everything to take you to the next level. So if you want to know how you can cut through the noise, you already know what to do. Stay tuned. Your girl's got you covered. Now, if this is your first time tuning into my channel, hi, hello, hey friends. My name is Shalane, and here on this channel, we discuss shopping, saving, and everything in between. I would love to have you a part of my internet family. Super easy. Click the big old red subscribe button down below when you're in, just like that. And while you're at it, go ahead and give me a like because you love me bringing this content to you and I enjoy doing it. I started this entrepreneurship journey in 2015. And over the years, I probably appeared on television maybe about 10 times. And in the newspaper, I don't know, 8 to 10 times. It's been a lot, okay? But these are some of the tips that I use to help me on my journey. One, you have to have personality. Like, sis, there is no way around it. If you are boring, if you are drab, if you are too serious, go ahead and exit stage left right now, because no one is gonna want you on television. Why do you think that the reality TV shows are like winning right now, right? Because these stars have the over-the-top personalities. They know that this actually produces ratings. Like, it's good for television. You wanna watch. This is why you tune in each and every single week to see what that character is gonna be saying, what they're gonna be doing, what's the catchphrase. This is why you tune in. Now,
because I am serving in the military, but also I'm still serving my community and just trying to juggle two hats. I mean, not only military, country, but my husband, you know, trying to be a good mother. Cut. I'm not a mom.
Are we announcing exciting news?
Just trying to be there with our family as well.
If you have the income, like, you know, you can always hire a publicist, but I've never hired a publicist because, like, just to retain a publicist, you're looking at about $3,000. But you're going to have to be able to hold a conversation, guys. If you can hold a conversation on live TV, keeping it going, that momentum going, you're gonna work well on being on TV, okay? Now, producers really hate that, like, yes, no, You have to keep it going, okay? You keep going until they say cut. Now, live TV, that's a whole different ball game, all right? Because you're going to have all these different alerts that's going to let you know to keep talking, when you need to stop. They're going to commercial break. Like, it's a lot that's going on. But people need to understand your vibe, connect to your vibe, and be able to, like, ride the wave. So, like, if you are a genuine person, that should be able to come out on television as well. Tip number two is presentation is everything. I mean, everything. And if you really want to secure the deal, you need to wear basic solid clothing with no logos at all. I mean, if you notice, most news anchors, they are simple and plain Jane on camera. Their hair is styled very neat and nicely. There's no trendy hairstyles, no visible tattoos, no big earrings, no body piercings, no loud, brightly colored clothing. You're not gonna see it, right? It's just not gonna happen. Why? Because it's distracting, y'all. It is very distracting to have someone who is giving you information and they got a lot going on. Like, no one is going to take you serious. Not in media, it's not. And this is exactly how I got selected for the Diva Fan on the Wendy Williams show. And I was able to get like a 1 minute segment. I was selected prior to actually the show going live. The stage producers pulled me, you know, to the side and they kind of prepped me and was like, hey, make sure when we go live, you cannot mention any household brands on air. You can't say New York and Company. You can't say Target. Why? Because they're going to be fined for that. So that's why I'm like, you can't wear those logos. Now, if you are a reoccurring guest on the show, or maybe you want a reoccurring position for them to come bring you out, you're going to have to tone it down. Like, that's what you're going to have to do. Also, you want to make sure like your social media platforms like is clean as a whistle. You don't want it unprofessional. You don't want it ratchet, like Rack City Chick. No, we are not going with that. But you're going to want to make sure you have it cleaned up before reaching out to any network, any news outlet. Because when I tell you, they're going to comb through your social media. They're going to comb through it, and sometimes they will even go back as far as a year. But they want to make sure that they can see like your personality through your posts. They want to make sure that you are posting content that is appropriate for their audience. So, I mean, guys, when you start talking about that television, that live, you got to be clean. Like, it has to be clean, mama. And I had to go and do it myself. So I'm saying, if this is what you want for your business, make sure that everything aligns when you go to apply and you're trying to get on television. Tip number three is to reach out to local news stations, email local magazines, and then also apply for casting calls. So you can always reach out to your local TV station via their website. Like, you can use the contact page. You can call them and ask to speak with the morning producer, or you can even show up at the news station. The main thing you need to be is persistent and really have something unique to pitch them. So just say if you have like a fashion or a lipstick business, you can ask them, can you be a style or a beauty expert? And you can go live and show them like several like beauty products, or you can do like product reviews, or even showcase like a fashion segment for mothers. I mean, you have to pitch this idea and sell it to them. Now, I've done this a lot in my city when it comes to local events, especially events that happen like once a year. So August 17th is National Thrift Store Day. And I've had where I went on the local news station and I've presented like five different items on television. I'll say, hey, you can get this from the thrift store for mothers or for children that are going back to school, or, you know, so just to do like where people are aware that it is National Thrift Store Day. Now, when you are emailing for casting calls, you're going to have to sell yourself. And I mean like oversell yourself. This is exactly what I did when I applied for Millennial Money. Like, I applied for that segment on how you can make money, spend money, earn money. Now, they did not select my story for the Millennial Money. But if you look at some of the previous stories that they have selected, they have where a nanny was making $270,000 a year. Like, guys, when you go to apply for a casting call through email, you are going to have to make your story sound so juicy, so good. Like, oh my gosh, we have to share this story. And that's what I did in my story. So while I did not get selected for Millennial Money, they pulled my application and was like, hey girl, can we go ahead and use you for a different segment? We are doing like an older millennial piece and we would love to feature your story. Absolutely, why not? That is more exposure to my YouTube channel. That is more exposure that I can put out on my media kit. That is more subscribers that I can get. That's more followers. So sometimes, guys, you have to be strategic in what you are applying for, because you never know who may come across your brand by having this media exposure as well. So it works for you, but you're gonna have to apply. And a lot of people do not use this benefit at all because maybe they're scared to actually talk on television. But if that's the case, girl, then apply for things that give like written material, you know, where it'll be an article. But you need to do something to get your business out there. Let's go ahead and go on to the next tip. Tip number four is you gotta be available. Now, if you work a full-time job, live television or daytime TV may not be for you, right? Because it is live, and in the media world, girl, they are not giving you no 2-week notice. They're not giving you time to prepare. You lucky if you get an hour or two. Everything is pretty much last minute and it can change daily. So you already have to have like that mentality. If they call me, girl, I'm gonna have to go ahead and clock out or tell them I'm sick or do something. Well, don't tell them to sit. You sick because you're gonna be on TV, right? But you may want to do some things and move some things around. But I'm telling you, you're going to have to be flexible if you want to make it. You're gonna have to sometimes drop everything and go, because people cancel all the time and you need to be ready. That's why I always tell you, you gotta stay ready so you don't have to get ready. Well, maybe Fabulous said that, but all right, whatever. But this exactly is what happened to me when I appeared in Young Jock's coffee shop video. Now, don't judge me, okay? This was so long ago, right? Obviously, this was my college years. I had no plan of being a video vixen or a video girl. It was like me and a few of my college girlfriends, we went to Atlanta for the weekend and we were just gonna party and have a good time. That's what you do in college, right? You drive to Atlanta. Got there, we discovered that we had left our flat iron in the dorm, right? So we end up going to the beauty supply store. I go in there and I bump into Young Jock. And when I bump into him, he's like super cool, chill. And he was like, oh, you're very pretty. Why don't you come be in my video I'm filming the next morning? I was like, okay, yeah, whatever, sure, right? And so he gives me the card to the producer, tells me to call the producer, get all the details. I thought he was lying. I thought it was a scam. Yeah, I did not believe it was true. So we get back home, we curl, we go out. I call the producer. The producer is like, sure, we have a spot for you. We want to give you like a lead role. Be there at 6 a.m. Well, me and my friends went out and we partied that night, right? So we kind of overslept. About 9, 10 a.m. we woke up and I'm like, oh, well, let's go ahead and go down to his photo shoot or to his video shoot and see if it's still going on or see if it's even true, right? We get there and guys, everyone is there. Like, you had Gorilla Zoe, you have Floyd, you have all these people that are there that's in Atlanta that's on this set. So I go find the producer and he's like, girl, you're late. Like, I told you to be here at 6. Everybody already got hair and makeup on. You're supposed to be one of these girls. We already filming. And so, y'all, I missed that opportunity because I was not available. I was not prepared. I did not know. But he said, you know what? We're still going to put you in the video. Just go ahead and get in here. And so that was only my 3 seconds of fame. So you guys seen it? That one, I mean, I was in there a lot longer, right? But when they did the final edit and the final cut, that's all I got. But it worked, right? It worked. And nonetheless, that exposure like really elevated me on the college campus, right? Because everybody's like, oh my gosh. At this time, it was jumping like Young Jock. I mean, you know, he ain't all that now. But at the time, it really, you know, just elevated my popularity on campus. And so sometimes, guys, when you are applying for these different positions, you really need to be prepared for media coverage because, like I said, it can change at any time. Last but not least is tip number 5, and that's to send promotional items. Now, if you know that television is not your thing, I feel you, I understand, but you can still take your items and send it to your friends, to celebrities, to public figures. I mean, it's not a guarantee that any person will necessarily wear it or you will make money from the exposure, but if you want the exposure of them possibly wearing your item, I would say to go ahead and send it to them anyway. Now, guys, if you notice, a lot of times I'm saying exposure, 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 because that's all that can happen when you put your brand or your business in the media on television. It is just exposure. It is not a guarantee that because you're in the media that you're going to get so many sales or that you're going to sell out at all. In fact, the only way that you can ensure that your business is going to sell is if you promote your business yourself. You shouldn't depend on this article, this television show, or this celebrity to make your business. It's up to you to build your business. And the last thing that you want is someone taking credit for putting your business on or putting your brand on. Like, you want to build it yourself, and then that way no one can ever say that they took it or they did it for you. And that's all I have, guys. If you really want to get your business or brand on television or in the media, these are some of the tips that you need to do. But let me know down below, have you ever appeared in a magazine, had your business appear on television? How did it work out for you? Did you see an increase in sales, or was it just like that good feeling that, hey, you have done something? Because that's always a great thing that you were selected out of all these applicants. And that's all I have. Please like, comment, subscribe, and I will talk to you tomorrow. Bye, guys.